Hello, and welcome to the next episode of the Live Your Spa Life Show. Spa Life is a lifestyle that accepts that accomplishment and harmony coexist. The spa in Spa Life, the SPA, is for seek power always, that internal power within you. You are going to love our guest today because we're going to be looking about the power of the mind. Dana Wilde is an expert in how you intentionally and systematically change your mindset so you get better outcomes. After growing her business from zero to $1 million a year in under 19 months, wow, Dana can teach you how to make money by being happy and getting paid for being you. What a concept. Hey, Dana, welcome to the show.
Hi, thanks for having me, Diane. I'm so excited to be here.
Oh, I've been looking so forward to this. I mean, you are just a rock star. You've got over 100,000 followers in 68 countries, and you're a best-selling author of Train Your Brain. And some people may not know, you're actually a movie star, girlfriend. Yes. I mean, you've been featured in The Abundance Factor, The Truth About Prosperity, and Dream Big. I mean, you have just been all over the place in this message that you have. And your fascination around neuroscience has really led you to your show, The Mind Aware Show, which I love so much, and the daily connection you have with people. Let's just jump in about how you intentionally think your way into being happier, healthier, and wealthier in your thoughts.
Sure. So how do you do it? Well, here's the thing. We all have the ability to focus and think in our own heads. You know, we are able to choose the clothes we wear. We choose the car we drive. We're concerned about the food we eat. We worry about the neighborhood we live in, all these other things. And I want people to start being more focused and more proactive about the thoughts that they think, because literally, you know, you hear all those sayings like what you think about you bring about and your thoughts create reality and all of these things, but nobody talks about why it's important. And that's really what I want to do.
Okay, girl. So why is it so important?
I just wanted to lead you up here. That's what I want now. Here we go. So here's the thing. Every single one of us has inside of our brains a part of the brain called the reticular activating system. The reticular activating system is like a little matchmaker that lives in your head. So think about right now, wherever you're sitting, look around the room you're in and look at all of the colors and the sounds and sensations and stimuli that are coming at you right this second. Well, billions and billions of bits of information are coming at you every second of every single day, and you can't possibly process all of that. So your reticular activating system does it for you. It sifts through all the mucky muck, and what does it pay attention to, or what does it notice? Whatever you're thinking about and whatever you're talking about. And so most of your audience members have probably had the experience of maybe thinking about buying a new car, or wanting to buy a new car, getting a different color car that's unique. Suddenly they start to see that car everywhere, or wanting to get pregnant, or just getting pregnant, or your partner just got pregnant, or you just had a baby and now you see pregnant women or babies everywhere. Well, that's your reticular activating system. But the thing that people have to understand is your reticular activating system is working on your behalf all day, every day. So whatever you're thinking about, it's saying, this must be important to you, so I'm looking for more of that.
Right. Now, Dana, what do you think about, you know, some of our the listeners may be going, well, I think mine's broken, right? Because I'm thinking these great thoughts, but I'm not getting the results I want. What do they do about that?
Well, give me an example of great thoughts they might be thinking.
Well, they could say something like, you know, I want to make $1 million, right? They're saying,
So stop right there. That's a really good one. So remember, your reticular activating system is like a little matchmaker that lives in your head. So what are you saying? I want to make $1 million. Okay, I'll match that up for you. I want to make $1 million, but that doesn't mean you did or you have $1 million. It just means you want to. And I'm your reticular activating system. I'm your best friend. I'll match it up. And equally, it works if you say, all of my clients are broke, or my boss is, you know, a blankety blank. You know, now what your reticular activating system says, got it. You're thinking about this. I'm going to look for all the times that your boss acts like a blankety blank. And I'm not going to look for any of those times that she or he supports you. I'm going to look for all those clients that don't pay you very much, because that's what's important to you, because you're thinking about it all the time. And what happens to most people, the reason why most people only experience incremental change in their lives or incremental growth in their businesses or incremental change in their health or the things that are important to them, is because what we tend to do is we tend to bump between frustration and hope, frustration, hope, frustration, hope. So we think a happy thought, and then we have the first little thing that knocks us off kilter, and then we focus on that. And then we try to get hopeful again. We think a happy thought. Then the little thing falls us kilter, and we try to go after that. And so we just ping pong through life like this, not really being in control of our outcomes. And what we're trying to do with Train Your Brain is we're trying to help you to understand that you can get more proactive about your thinking. You can get more proactive about the way the thoughts you choose to think, about the things that you focus on, not for a whole day, for just 60 seconds or 120 seconds, and then you start to get momentum, and then it becomes easier to attract other thoughts. And what happens when you get proactive for a 72-hour period, then your reticular activating system kicks in. You start to see the evidence that what you're doing is working within 3 days, not 21 days, not 30 days, within 72 hours.
Wow. That's huge.
Yeah, it is huge. And it is. And it's fun. And that's why it's fun to be a brain trainer, because once you get this, you start to go, oh my gosh, I can do this for anything, you know?
Right. And you just kind of start that momentum going and that success building on success. And then that becomes the more frequent actually part of your process, right?
Yeah. Do you want to know the four steps to how to do this?
Yes.
Okay. So step one is what I call the wake up call, the be aware step. So this is the time where it's time to wake up, to be aware. Brain scientists estimate that we are in an unconscious state, unaware, about 95 to 99% of the day. So if you ever had that experience of, like, you know, driving, right? You're 10 miles down the road and you're like, whoa, I just woke up, or brushing your teeth. We do everything automatically.
Right, right.
You don't have to become like a Zen monk. If you can just kind of wake up for about a half a percent of the day, set some reminders on your phone just to say, like, hey, what are you thinking now? Or check in with yourself, put some post-it notes up that kind of remind you, like, hey, be aware, and start to check in with yourself. And we know, we don't need a post-it note to know that when we say that thing, like, oh, I'm so stupid, I'm never going to get it anyway, or this always happens to me. Like, just bust yourself, wake up and bust yourself and be like, okay, I just did that. I just had that thought, like, oh, I'm getting so fat, or, oh, you know, it's not working for me, or any of those things. Then step two is decide. Do you want your reticular activating system to keep matching this up? Because it's going to do it whether you want it to or not. And so something like, I for years said, I am not a morning person. But right. I didn't care. I didn't want to be a morning person. So I didn't care if it kept matching that up. But right. Some things you say you don't want to keep matching up. And right. If that's the case, then step three is you must begin to find a way to talk about the current situation in a way that feels good. And that's where all the kind of work is, or play, like we like to call it. That's where all the play is. And we can talk about that. And then step four is feel the positive emotion. So feel the positive emotion that comes from it. You know, don't be an automaton just walking through life, letting things happen to you and go like, well, I'm going to have to feel this way because that happened. No, you think in your head, you decide how you're going to feel in any moment. You can live in this place. That doesn't mean that, you know, technology doesn't make you mad every so often, but you know how to get back to this good feeling place. And then you take action from this place and you're on fire. You're a powerhouse. You can do anything. So those right. are the four steps.
I love that. So let's go back here to, like, the first part of it, that awareness. Mm-hmm. I think, you know, awareness is so important. You know, a lot of times when people have the awareness, they almost may have like a secondary thought where there's, like, you know, judgment or shame or something that comes around with that, right?
You're so smart. That's exactly right.
So it's kind of like, great, I'm aware of it. Now I'm continuing to, you know, have these things that are not supporting me. And so now you get stuck in the bad thoughts.
Well, you don't get stuck in the bad thought if you're doing the Train Your Brain method.
Okay,
because
perfect.
You only get, because what we say is, when you have an aware thought and you realize, like, I just said something really negative,
okay.
That's not the time to beat up on yourself. That's the time to go, oh my God, I just had an aware thought. I'm not walking around on automatic pilot. I'm going to celebrate, right? Yes, I'm so happy that I'm right. awake. I get it. Now I can actually go to step two and decide if I want to keep thinking this. Because you know what the alternative is of not being aware? being on automatic pilot and just automatically generating your results. So of course you don't beat yourself up, because you get in the habit of realizing, like, this is so awesome that I just busted myself. I just busted myself thinking that thing that I always think, oh my gosh. And we, you know, have moments where, of course, we go, cancel, pop, pop. Like, why did I do it again? You know, but for the most part, it starts to be, that's where the fun is, because the negative thoughts never go away. I've been doing this for 30 years. And if somebody's figured out how to make them go away, good for you. But what I can tell you is you'll catch them faster and you'll turn them around faster, and they will not influence your life or your outcomes in the way that, you know, they do for most people, or even like they might've done for you in the past.
Right. Absolutely. Well, you know, just in the spirit of this, we're going to bust our listeners who are probably driving in their car right now and we're on automatic pilot and maybe didn't capture those four things. So let's give it to them again.
Sure. Step one, be aware. This is the wake up step. Pay attention. What are you thinking about, talking about, feeling about? You know, sometimes you don't have words for it, but you know, like, I feel stressed. Okay, well, start to name it. Step two, decide. Is this what I want my reticular activating system keep matching up? Do I want my reticular activating system to match this? Because it is matching it. So you have to decide if you want it to do that or not. And if you don't, step three, you must begin to talk about the current situation in a way that feels good. And step four, feel the positive emotion that you generate from that step three. And step three is where all the trouble is, you know, and trouble's the wrong word. See, I'll bust myself. Where all the challenge is, and challenge is the wrong word. Where all the opportunity for growth is. And what we like to say is where all the fun is and where all the play is, because, you know, it's hard, you know, traditional affirmations. And I'm a big believer in those too. We call them mantras, and they work without a shadow of a doubt. Those things like money is flowing to me and I'm a money magnet and all those happy things. But when you're in a feeling of frustration or anger or worry, you can't hear those things. You know, those happy, positive people that come up to you and are like, you know, you bring about what you think about, like, they just make you angry. You don't want to hear any of that. So you have to find a way to talk about the current situation in a way that feels good.
Right.
So can I tell you a story about a guy that we worked with? Okay. There was a guy that we worked with, and he was very shy, and he was trying to get his project made, and he would go to these networking events to meet people, investors and things like this. And he'd walk into the room, and he didn't have to look at a list of, like, personality characteristics to know that he was shy and to know how he would react. His reticular activating system would automatically make his palms sweat and his breathing would get shallow, and he'd start to stutter and he couldn't string a sentence together. He couldn't communicate. But that wasn't really the problem. The problem was that when he would leave the event, he would beat himself up. I'm so stupid. Nobody's ever going to want to work with me. I can't even get a sentence together. I wouldn't want to work with me either. You know, this is the worst. On and on and on, beating himself up over and over and over again. Now, the brain doesn't know the difference between what's real and what's imagined. So when you imagine that, it's like you just had it happen 1,000 times, and you create all this emotion around it. And then the emotion reinforces the unconscious mind. So then the next time the reticular activating system will match it up again. And then you complain about it again. And then you reinforce it again. And then the reticular activating system matches up. Then you complain some more, and then it reinforces it, and round and round it goes. We call this the cycle of perpetual sameness. And so what am I going to tell shy guy? Am I going to say, you know, you should walk around saying, I'm an extrovert? Like, no, because it's kind of ridiculous, you know? And so what we did is we gave him, we have lots of mind hacks with Train Your Brain. And one of them is called a transitory statement. And one of the many transitory statements we give is using the word but. Because the word but negates everything that comes before it. So we said, start saying things like, I'm shy, but people like my style. I'm shy, but I connect with the right people. Because now the brain doesn't hear anything that comes before it, but what it does reinforce is anything that comes after it. Ah. So I'm shy, but I'm connecting with the right people. I'm shy, but I'm getting my projects made. I'm shy, but people like my style. I'm shy, but things are working out for me. Right. All of these things. And people, if you're a procrastinator or you're disorganized or you're any of those things, you can use this word but to still get positive results. I think many of us, you know, I work with entrepreneurs. So entrepreneurs, they have this idea that you have to be a certain way in order to be successful. There's this image of this successful person.
Sure.
And what I would try to explain to them is that the only thing the same among successful people is that they think successfully and they have an expectation for success. So it doesn't matter if you're not techie. I'm not techie, but I'm still building my business. I'm not techie, but I'm finding other ways. I'm not techie, but I get tons of clients. I'm not techie, but my business is rocking. Like, you know, your brain only hears what you tell it. And then that reticular activating system wants to match it up. Does that all make sense?
It makes total sense. And I love this so much because I was actually taught about don't use the word, but because of the negation that it does, that it's always and inclusive, but I've never heard it where you actually use but in a positive way to purposely negate things that are happening. So it's a brilliant way to use the word, but when you actually do want to negate things. And I love that so much. And I also love the example of what you actually showed in the moment of where you said like, this is challenging, but now it's not challenging. And you were changing the words as you go. Part of me was thinking about, so when you first said challenging, did the reticular activator like hear that and now I'm on a path, or you can change it right away with either a but or whatever? Or like, I'm just thinking like when people are saying like, this happened, this said, how do I shift and change out of that? So that how quickly does the reticular activator, you know, react to what it is that we're saying when that was maybe a misspeak?
Oh yeah. If the idea here is it's about consistency and, you know, being as aware as you can. Sometimes I don't catch stuff. And if I don't catch it, luckily, cause I talk about this all the time, I'm always in a crowd of people where somebody will bust me on it. And it's fun, you know, to be around people who get this. Cause then you go, oh yeah, I did just say that, didn't I? No, I don't want to say that. And you don't have to feel bad about the beliefs that we've been, you know, we all were raised in these same cultures. We're all raised with these same ideas of you know, limiting beliefs that we get indoctrinated to. And so what happens is now, instead of it being a big old bad that we have to try to be perfect, it's the opposite. What it's about is it's about really accepting who we are as we are and knowing that we have everything we need to be successful and knowing that we can live a happy life and we can be authentically ourselves and be out in the world and find your tribe, and you're going to find the people that you resonate with and you're going to have fun doing this. Now, if I continually say or think something on automatic pilot, the reticular activating system is going to continue to match that up. And I hope and am sure of that for my entire life, I will keep peeling back layers of things that are limiting beliefs that I find are true. I always say that I hope I look back at my life a year before and cringe, because then I know like I'm growing so much and I'm growing by leaps and bounds that, you know, there's always going to be something. That's called being alive for me. Right. So I really don't ever want people to be afraid of their words or afraid that, you know, that's that old joke, cancel, cancel, pop, pop. It's more about being on the path and having fun with it rather right. than feeling limited. Most mindset people, they want you to feel like you have these hidden things in your brain that are sabotaging you. And I want to say, none at all. Your brain's your best friend. And I want you to play nice with it and find ways to like have good dialogues with it and have good dialogues with yourself, because then what will happen is you'll start to have that forward moment. You'll start to feel happy. And that is the thing, which I'd love to talk about more if you like.
Yeah, absolutely. We'll jump into that here in just a moment. One of the things that, you know, I'm just thinking about what some of our listeners may be in as far as the path of that is. So what's your stance on, you know, the cancel, cancel, pop, pop, and saying those things right away? I mean, I know you use the word but to cancel out. Are those things that you use? Are they not necessary? I know that that's kind of popular.
I don't use cancel, cancel, pop, pop, but it's not because I don't think it's necessarily a bad thing. I think anything that makes you aware and laugh and smile is a good thing. And we're always trying different things just to make ourselves kind of feel silly about it and laugh about it. The most important way that you can turn something around is to ask yourself, how would I talk to my best friend about this? Or how would I talk to my child about this? If your child came up to you and said, you know, I'm having trouble, you know, I work with entrepreneurs, right? So let's say they said, I'm having trouble finding clients. You wouldn't say, yeah, you're so stupid. They're never going to be a success. You know, we would never do that. We would say like, oh, you're going to be all right. You're going to figure it out and take your time and you'll find your way and you'll find your method and you'll find your marketing strategy, and other people have figured it out. You are too. So I want to encourage people in that step three, where you're finding a way to talk about the current situation in a way that feels good. You may not be able to walk around saying, I have $1 million business and money flows to me in great quantities, but you might be able to say like, okay, I'm not where I want to be right now, but I'm on my way and I'm willing to learn and I'm open and I'm feeling better and I'm going to find my way, and other people have done it and I can too, and I'm going to have more faith in myself and I'm going to keep my eyes open. And it's so important because, and this is really like the key, when you start to get yourself to that good feeling place, hope and above, the creative pathways in your brain now open up. So when you're in frustration and below, in the emotional scale, the creative pathways in your brain shut down. You literally don't have access to good ideas. You start feeling good. Think about when you start feeling good.
Right. Creative
pathways open up. You start getting ideas. You feel like taking action. You feel like engaging. People want to be around you. You feel like picking up that phone. You like people better. They like you better. You get better results. You get in the zone. So like you work less because you're in that feeling high flying place. It's like everything you touch turns to gold. So I want to encourage people, not only in business, but in life, to make that their number one priority, feeling good, being happy. Because if you do that, the results you get are better all the way around in everything, right?
Absolutely. And I definitely want to get into that conversation around, you know, it seems so happy about, we'll just, or so easy to say, just be happy, right? Yeah. I mean, it seems like this elusive, you know, trail for some people. And it's just, that's why I love where you're saying, like, getting paid for being happy and being you. It's just like, well, that seems to be the path that it should be for everyone. However, it seems to be sometimes be the, or can be the biggest nemesis that people can experience in how they are in their life. And I know too that, you know, some people can live their life by default, where it just kind of happens to them. And I know that you are all about consciously creating your life and designing in that in the way. How is designing your life? What does that look like for you? And how do you bring that happiness equation into it?
Yeah, great question, Diane. You're so good. So here's the thing. People do have this idea that my emotions are something that happens to me, or my energy level. It's like energy level or emotions as weather. You know, I've got widely scattered anger tonight, followed by depression in the morning. You know, like it have, like it's externally motivated. And it's not to say that there aren't things that knock us off kilter. Right. You know, I know on any given day, I feel like throwing my computer through the window, you know, so there are things that do get our, there are more trigger buttons, or they are, you know, more likely to knock us off kilter. And that's okay. I'm not saying, in fact, I don't even want to walk through life all blissed out. I really don't. I think that would be boring. It's not what I signed up for. All of my big growth moments come in those moments when I'm, you know, having less than desirable moments. That's when I have bigger desires. So, but here's what I know without a shadow of a doubt, and your listeners can test them for this for themselves. Have them, whenever this audio is over, sit in whatever chair you're sitting in, close your eyes, and think about something that's stressing you out. And just take a moment, like 60 seconds, and it's pretty easy to think thoughts about the thing that's stressing us out, because usually we're thinking a lot about it anyway. And just notice, like, where do I feel it in my body? And what kind of emotion would I call it? Like, would I call it anger or frustration or sadness or pain, or what would it be? Then stand up, shake it off, sit down again, and think of a place I would call your happy place. So imagine what it is. And it can be like a bathtub or a beach or a recliner or a, you know, hammock under a willow tree. It doesn't matter. Pick anything, even a place you've never been. And close your eyes and just think, like, okay, what are the smells I smell around here? And what are the sounds? And what am I feeling? And then again, give it a name. So is the name like peace or happiness or joy or ease, or what would be the name? And then just feel like, where is it happening in the body, this feeling of peace? And then what I challenge them to do when they're done is to recognize the fact that they generated both of those opposing emotions just by their imagination, or just by pretending, or just by thinking about a place. Thinking about the things that bother and stress you out will cause you to feel stress. Thinking about things that are relaxing and peaceful, like your happy place, will cause you to feel happy and relaxed and peaceful. And you're sitting in the same chair, in the same room, with the same environment, and nothing has changed except the thoughts you're thinking. And what happens when you start to play with this work and you start to really get aware and you start to really realize, like, oh my gosh, every time I'm having a negative emotion, it's because I'm thinking some thought that's generating a negative emotion. I'm thinking some thought that almost always, if not always, I haven't ever found a time, but it's not true. You're thinking a thought that isn't even true. There's no basis in reality for it, but we're generating negative emotion over it. And what you start to figure out soon is that rather than pretending to be blissed out, or rather than putting on a happy face over things that are painful, what happens is you realize you can actually literally shift your emotions just by changing the way you think about them. And the shift then is real and it's internal, and you feel the change no matter how far down the emotional scale you are.
Right. You know, Dana, I mean, and this is just so amazing, just how you, I mean, I love just the fact that you're actually in the same chair and you're having polar experiences that are happening. And, you know, I'm kind of listening to what some of the listeners are at. And some of the things that come up is like, you know, well, that sounds all well and good for you, but I was raised with a negative environment and positive thinking, like that just never worked for me. So what do you do to support those people?
Yes, thank you. Great, great question. And you're right in the head of like the general population of masses. So here's the thing to know. First of all, the first thing I can tell you is the more negative you've been in your life and the more negative your environment that you were raised in, the faster this works for you. And the reason why is because if you think about it, think about, you know, the average positive person out there, the average natural optimist. Well, I can take their life and I can maybe raise them from like a 7 to a 9 in their life. Mm-hmm. But the average person who's been raised in a negative environment or who's always had a lot of self-doubt or has always beat themselves up, they have been getting the results they're getting banging around with that attitude. So you can't imagine, like when you start to apply just like a smidgen of this, you start to just get results by leaps and bounds. Right. So that's the first thing I want to say. The more negative you are, the faster this is going to work for you and the better it's going to work for you. Then the second thing is, all of us have areas of our lives where, at least speaking for myself, and I'm guessing most of the population, we have areas of our lives where we have patterns of thought or habits of thought where we feel stuck, and or we feel like we're extra negative about, or we feel like this is an issue we're not going to be able to get over. And that is the play of train your brain. The play of train your brain is not expecting to go in there and, okay, I've been thinking negative on this one topic of money for 30 years, and today I'm going to spend 120 seconds with Dana and I'm going to be done with it forever. Okay, that's not what this is about. This is about really making a shift from the inside out and getting better and better and better at it as you go along and incrementally figuring out what feels better. Once you start to do that, it becomes really fun. You know, so I do a thing that people sometimes call rants, because I just, you know, string a bunch of sentences together and it's a positive rant. So somebody's feeling frustrated about money. They're thinking like, well, what can I think in my head? I mean, I've never had money. I feel stressed out about money. And what can I think about? Well, you obviously aren't going to go changing all the way up the bliss scale right now. So what can you think about? Well, you can think things like, okay, I'm open to this idea. I'm open to the idea of training my brain. I have tried a lot of things. I don't like how I feel. I don't like being stressed out about money. So I'm open to trying this. And I can tell, like right now I'm focused on this one thought, and I get it that I can only think one thought in my head, even if it doesn't feel like that. But I like that I'm aware now and I can focus on this thought and I can think of a sentence to say. And I know I may not be able to think of another sentence right away, but I'm open to the idea of learning how to do this. And I'm open to the idea of using my brain. I'm open to the idea of feeling better about this. In fact, I'm so ready to be feeling better about this. Like, I'm so sick of it. I hate feeling that way. And I'm looking forward to feeling better. And I don't know what to say to do that, but that's okay. Because I know that this is a path, and data says it'll take time. And so I'm moving forward and I'm trying. And I'm moving in the direction of it, and I'm open to things coming my way. And I know that people have breakthroughs all the time, and I could have a breakthrough just like anybody else could. It could happen to me. And so I'm ready for that. And I'm going to just trust that if I stay on this path and I see what she says, because I'm already starting to feel better. I haven't even said that much that's that interesting. And I can start to feel that I'm feeling the relief of it. And it's getting easier to think of things to say, because I can feel that I'm starting to feel a little lighter around this. I'm starting to feel a little hopeful. And I do like that feeling of hope. And I can see that when I'm in this feeling more consistently, that things could open up for me. And I'll bet that my reticular activating system is starting to look for stuff that's probably been there. But when I'm in hope, I feel like I start to see it. And I think this could work for me. And this feels really good. Like, I kind of like that I feel this way, and this is fun. And I'm going to keep focusing on things. I'm going to keep moving in this direction. And this could be a whole change for me, and things could change on a dime. And I'm open to miracles. Here it is, you know? So what happens, we just spent 60 seconds doing that, 90 seconds. And you could feel the shift. I think most of you could feel the shift from the place we started out to where we are now, just saying sentences that really, really aren't all that perfect the language, or they aren't perfect affirmations or mantras, but they're things you can feel that they feel better when you say them. Does that make sense?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. And I could feel as you were going through that process of that, just it's possible, the possibility, going from the possibility to then kind of looking like, well, I could see how this works for other people, and then maybe it'll happen for me and that type of thing. But when you hit hope, there was something you said about the threshold of hope, that when you open up hope, then it just opens up something bigger. And even the lightness of, even your voice got lighter, and the things that started happening. So I love the spiraling of that, because one of the things I think that comes up is people sometimes feel like they're lying to themselves when they're saying these positive words, because they'll go from like, you know, broke to like, you know, I'm a millionaire. And it's like, it's such a chasm for people in their brain that they feel like it's like, it just doesn't compute for them. Yeah. So to actually have a bridge in utilizing the language to actually use it in your favor, to actually have a way to get there, is brilliant.
Yeah, we call it the emotional scale. And you hit it on the head when you talked about hope. You know, I always tell entrepreneurs, you may not be in believing or knowing or bliss about your business, but you don't have to be. If you can just be feeling hopeful more consistently, intentionally trying to feel hopeful, your brain will take you the rest of the way. You know, so just like, if that's your number one job, and if you can't do anything else, just say a bunch of hope sentences. You know, I hope I feel better. I hope I think of another sentence. I hope my business builds. I hope a customer comes out of the blue and buys something, you know, just say that, and it'll start to get you moving in the right direction. But it doesn't have to be. But I guess the thing I really want people to know is that people think of happiness as something they'll have when it either, like, the weather it's bestowed on them or something happens to them. And what I want people to start to really understand more and more is that happiness is the path. When you get happy and when you feel good, you're utilizing your best brain. You get your whole system on board working toward whatever it is that you want, or more accurately, playing toward whatever it is that you want. And frankly, you live a better life. I mean, who doesn't want to be happy? You live in this place. You know, I have moments where I'm off center, but for the most part, you have a better life.
Absolutely. Well, and I know that, you know, Dana, you're famous for saying that action's not the path to success. So why is that?
Well, if you take, let's say, 100 people in 100 different industries who are all at the top of their industry, and you ask them, what action did you take to get successful? They're going to say like, oh, LinkedIn's where it's at. And then the next one's going to say, oh, no, you have to be on Facebook. And the next one's going to say live streaming. And the next one's going to say, get offline and go to a networking meeting. And they're going to have 100 different answers for how to be successful. But so, and they all work. I mean, those are all viable reasons, but it can't be the action that got them there, because they all did it 100 different ways. But the one thing that they will have in common is they will all have a certain way of thinking. And the thing with successful people is that they think this way naturally. So what happens in our culture is there's a certain percentage of the population that gets successful almost on accident, because they are naturally born thinking this way, or this is kind of their bent. This is how they think. And when you ask them, how'd you do it? They'll say LinkedIn, because nobody thinks to say, well, I think different thoughts than other people, and that's why I'm successful. But that is the one thing they all have in common. And that's what we're trying to do with Train Your Brain, is we're trying to teach you how to think like that. And of course, we've discovered you can. It's not really that hard. You just have to have a desire and a willingness to bust yourself, and a willingness to laugh at yourself, and a willingness to play with some language. Because once you start playing with that language, your body will respond, and you'll start to feel the feelings that shift when you use different words.
Oh, this is so powerful because it's so, it's an easy step to do. I mean, because you know, if you had to rely on the actions, you could be throwing all kinds of things out there, but starting with the thoughts and what that could be is just so powerful. And so what would be another exercise that our listeners could implement right away where they could get some results?
Yes, this is a really good one and they'll have so much fun with this. So what I started to realize, because I get asked this all the time on podcasts and interviews and stuff, like what's one I can use? And so I thought, I started giving this out and then I started hearing from podcast hosts like, okay, people are having so many results with this. So I thought, okay, this is my new thing. So here's what it is. If you imagine whatever it is that you're having a challenge with, so maybe it's finding clients or maybe it's losing weight or, you know, finding the person of your dreams or whatever it is that your issue is, create a mantra for yourself and think of it as it says, blank is so easy. Okay, so it could be making money is so easy. Finding clients is so easy. Losing weight is so easy. Finding the man of my dreams is so easy, right? Because the is so easy mantra, it's almost a little ludicrous and it's almost a little like ridiculous that we would say it. So it's funny. Like if you've been struggling with your weight your whole life and then to start going, oh, losing weight is so easy. You know, if you can laugh at that and have fun with it and say it 25 to 50 times a day, or more if you feel like it, but at least 25 to 50 times a day. And you don't have to believe in it, which is contrary to what you hear from everybody else.
Right.
But you can't argue with it. So it can't be like losing weight is so easy. No, it's not. You know, it's got to be like, ooh, losing weight so easy. Almost like you're just like trying to make yourself cracked up and do it. Right. So do it 25 to 50 times a day. And what will happen is by the end of 72 hours, your reticular activating system will kick in and you'll start to see the evidence in your outside world that it's working. So you'll start to see
this so much. I'm laughing because I was just talking with one of my mentors yesterday. And one of the things that we were talking about is like, what if it was just easy?
Yeah. That is so good. Mwah. I just adore you. That's exactly right. What if it was just easy? And that's the thing. You know, we have these expectations that building a $1 million business is hard or losing 100 pounds is hard. We have these ideas that's hard. And you're right. What if it was easy? What if it was?
Oh my gosh. Oh my God. And it's so funny. I'm actually later today going to be doing a show about, are you done with it being hard?
Boom. That's exactly it.
Oh my God. This is so great. Oh, this is so wonderful.
That synchronicity is what that is. Right? Like really, we are just like a simpatico in vibe with this. That's so good.
So wonderful. Well, Dana, you and I could talk all day long here. And I know that our listeners are going to want to connect with you and you have a really hot gift for them. You know, can show them how you can do that.
Yes, I do have a hot gift for them. This is actually my entire book and it's on the audio form of the entire book. It's so train your brain. You can get it in physical form, but I found if you're like me, you like to listen to the audio of it. And I want to give you the URL. I believe it's danawild.com/yourspaLife.
So I'm going to just straight spa life and we'll have
spa life. Is that what I did? There we go. I know this is called Dana not being prepared, but
it's all right. You that you rely on the systems and it's all going to be in the show notes anyway.
Well, and on top of that, I knew that I was with a host who like, you always dot your I's and cross your T's. Like you're the most organized, awesome person, Diane. So that's it. Yeah. Spa life, danawild.com/spa life and get the whole book for free. Cause you'll see all the 20 mind work experiments are in there. You'll have fun with this.
Thank you so much. This is amazing. And I know that they're also going to want to connect with you further so they can check you out on your show, the Mind Aware Show, and we'll have all your links and things in there. And
thank you.
Thank you so much for just, you know, lending your brain to us and making it an easy process and making it fun. I mean, who knew that just being happy and it being fun and making it easy is actually the path.
Yeah, exactly. And thank you for having me. I love the work you're doing and I just think you've got a powerful mission and I really appreciate getting to be a part of this sandbox. Thank you.
Oh, my pleasure. And for our listeners here, I know that you're maybe jumping in this conversation and wondering like, how can you be supported? And another resource that will also be in the show notes is to take a mylifereset quiz.com to see where you're being, you know, successful and where you need to have some support. And no matter what, you know, forum that you're listening to us, please subscribe to both of our shows and be part of the community to and be part of the conversation. And we would love to hear, and please tag both, you know, Dana Wilde and myself with any questions that you have, any support that you need, because we really do want to connect with you and make sure that you have all the tools to move forward in the life that you want to have. And so we really appreciate that. And most importantly, you know, one of the best assets that you have is your time. And we're so appreciative that you decided to spend that time with us. And so until we connect again, live your spa life. Bye for now. See ya. Ta-da!